Yes.
So I am very much delighted to have Mistri sir sparing time for this thing, because this ultra fine powders as performance improvers need to be taught to our students. Mistri sir, we have participants from 21 states, and most of them, around 80% of them, are teachers, and 10% are research scholars, maybe M.Tech or the PhD scholars, and then rest 10% are field engineers and so. So it's a good blend, and most of them are teachers. So I believe that these teachers will take along this session proceedings with them and disseminate to their students. Particularly field engineers who are attending are also requested to, because this area is not well documented in books till now. Whichsoever books we are teaching with are not finding ultra fine powders. Particularly the new books are getting this coverage, maybe new books on concrete technology, but and good books of overseas particularly, but not MS Shetty like that, or the traditional books on concrete technology, which are being used as textbooks. Even A.M. Neville, which is being referred as treatise for concrete, teaching concrete technology, properties of concrete, at that time, because he wrote 50, 60 years ago, he died being in 90s, like Dilip Kumar ji. So Neville does not at that time conceive ultra fine powders. So Neville is being treated as Gita for concrete technologists, Neville's properties of concrete. But nevertheless, we should learn from the developments, and these are the developments in the last 20 years in the country as well as in the world. So over to Mr. Sir.
Okay, is my screen visible or
Your face is
can you
visible,
see
sir.
my screen?
Your PPT is
Face
not
is
visible.
visible. One second. Let me check how it is to be connected actually.
Previously it came when
Yeah, I stop actually sharing and
in the bottom there is a
it's
tab.
checking.
In the bottom there is a
No,
tab.
I know actually, but I'm just searching where I opened the things and
Actually, WebEx is not so popular. So in the bottom toolbar, there is mute, unmute, stop video, then upward arrow saying share. So from that share, you just
No,
click.
yes. That's what I'm searching. Just keep the track actually. I know, but
Sir.
where it was, yes, this is the things I can share, I can select. Okay.
Yes, it has come, sir. Perfect.
This is the one, and this is the second one, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is changing, sir.
Okay, so fine, perfectly right. So I was just checking because today, fine. Shall we, can we start?
Yes, sir, please, kindly.
Okay. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity, and it is nothing like that, any busy meeting and all. It is all for the industries, what product we produce, which has to be reached to the maximum advantages, students as well as the industry people and all actually. Today we are going to talk for the two product. One is the metakaolin, which is already there in IS 456 and independent IS standards are also there. And a few slides we are talking about ultra fine material also, which is not reactive one and non-reactive one. Reactive one, it is a non-reactive one. So first we'll start to understand metakaolin first, And before we start, I would like to say thank you very much to all of you for sparing your time, and hope your all the earlier session was also quite on time. And I'm also hoping this details of Metaqlin also will help to understand how Metaqlin is being produced, what are important parameters to be taken care while production as well as while using into the concrete and cement product. The first, okay, my slide is not changing. I don't know why. Yes, now it is perfect. The first, we'll see the introduction part, how it is produced, this metakaolin, because it is an indigenously produced product. Once it is produced, then what is the physical properties of that metakaolin need to be controlled. Again, the chemical compositions and chemical properties. We did some experiment also. I'm going to share a few mixed designs. And these are all mixed designs, not in laboratory scale. It is on a production scale, proper the site scale, and the advantages and the applications. So first, why metakaolin is needed? Before talking to the metakaolin, we have to understand the concrete, like a high value concrete. This is the things for what we all are, you know, working for, the filler material as well as the metakaolin kind of pozzolanic material. This high value generally associated with the high performance, and this high performance concrete, want to produce a high performance concrete, we need a selective properties to be taken care for that concrete. Mean to say, if we need a high value concrete, means it has to be a high strength, that concrete property. It has to be a good flexural strength. This concrete, it's required all chemical control and chemical resistance also is needed. Low permeability is one, and low chloride and permeability, otherwise low chloride penetrations. These are the few selected properties to be always addressed and controlled in a such a manner so that we can produce a high value concrete. And what material is generally used for, it is all well known, all people are well, actually, it is not like not a new things, but yes, it is mentioned like a material used for the high value concrete is like a blended cement or the Portland cement is. Without this, it is difficult to construct any of concrete nowadays. No doubt there are other products are also there. Some research are going on geopolymer concrete and all. But yes, today's scenario, the Portland cement and blended cements are the important material. As far as this cement, there are a few of cementitious material which helps to enhance the durability and high strength, and we are talking about metakaolin today. Yes, there are other minerals are also available to support and enhance the durability and high strength and all. Apart from that, chemical admixtures are also, it is an essential things to achieve desired properties of a flowability, water reductions, some retarders, some accelerators, and the sinkage control chemicals are, that is also support a lot to get high value concrete. And material is the one, but how to use that material, that is also an important factor here. So the optimum aggregates are used, but it is required always an optimum level, optimum graded aggregates that always helps to improve workability and reduce the pest control and all actually. So these are the product we use, and we are talking about the metakaolin. And nowadays it is, you can see the field of concrete technology has seen a sea change in the past decades. Since many decades, we are working for many different products, and metakaolin among the one actually. And nowadays, yes, many limitations of concretes are being bunkered through new innovation, new inventions, and all day by day, new things are, you know, the industry people and scientists and engineers are searching for. And metakaolin is one of them. in the family of the cement mixture, I can say, to produce quality concrete, high value concrete, high strength concrete, high durable concrete. First, we have to understand what is metakaolin actually. So metakaolin is a specially produced product. It is not at all a byproduct actually. Kaolin is, it's a off color or maybe a white colored fine clay available in the mines. Use and the manufacturer of generally porcelain or many other paper industries and all are they use. And meta denotes to the changes actually. So what we do actually, we change kaolin into the meta stage of kaolin actually. It's a refined kaolin and which is fired under carefully controlled temperature. So by doing this, thermal activation of that raw clay, or not a raw clay, I'm just going to present how the clay is derived from the mines and how we process. And that we, fire up to certain temperature, and that is create as an amorphous aluminosilicate. That amorphous silicate is the reactive in nature, and it is reactive in concrete. So we can say it is a kaolin, given a properly thermally treated kaolin, we can say. Few of the grades I mentioned here, like a Meta-75C and Meta-Kaolin, Meta-Plus, these are few grades we give. Here you can see this all step-by-step how it is produced. The main activity to get a right quality of material at my plant or any of the Meta-Kaolin production plant is a mining, lavigation, refining, grit removing, drying of powder and all. Some calcination is the important parameter and the particle size control. Here you can see downside the first like a mining one photographer you can see actually. Mine is, these are open mine product which is having the aluminosilicate, and this kaolin is a very soft in nature. That kaolin is contained almost 75 to 80% of a silica grit, and 25 to sometime less than a 10% also, depending on the reserves. Right quality of kaolin is available in the mine. India is having almost 2,500 million tons of reserves is available. So first I wanted to convey that this product is well available, means the raw material is very much available. It could, according to Bureau of Indian Mines, you can see the data of lot of all across the India, this raw material is available comfortably. So as far as we is concerned, we are producing this in the western part of India, but the raw material is available in eastern part of India, available in the south part of India, and also in the center part of India. North mining activity is always limited, and to the extent of Rajasthan, yes, it is available. So this raw material comes from the mines, we excavate, identify dried clay, and then we convert into the second picture. You can see water treatment and purification is required. So whatever raw comes from the mines, we need to convert into the water slurry. That slurry is in the level of 10% of solid and 90% is the water. So it is a very small quantity of raw material is being used, maximum is the water. And we are taking all the care of recycling the water, reprocess of the water, refining the water so that environment, we can control this and no, wastage is to be generated at the plant. So that is the one thing I wanted to convey. And after that slurry, what it is removed from that clay converted into that slurry, we floating technology, we extract clay and removing grit. So you can say removing grit activity is also a water treatment and purification stage as done. This slurry we passing through cryogenic magnetic separator. You can see the orange color of machine. This is the only instrument in Asia. This is work on minus 270 degrees. It's a chilling plant actually. So paramagnetic impurity, whatever there, paramagnetic impurities are there in the clay, which we remove and get a pure refined kaolin, which is having a consistent quality of chemical consistency, I can say, and a very refined stage of clay comes out. in a form of slurry that we are removing water by using a filter press. You can see that right top corner, there is a such kind of a filter press we are removing and convert into the lumps and then into the powder form by using a sunlight or any of the thermal low temperature firing activity and all. After getting that refined kaolin powder, this powder we are doing thermally treatment. Like generally this calcined kaolin is a rotary kiln. One side we fired the temperature, the starting zone is 1800 to 850 degrees, and the end zone is 400 temperature. So we pass through that powder. It's a similar kind of cement producers are producing cement. It is a, but these are a smaller kiln, not like a cement kiln actually. So this kiln help us to convert kaolin into meta stage of kaolin, meta kaolin. And the temperature is crucial. Residential time is also we have to, you know, maintain in a such a way so that the bonding between alumina and silica is get separated out. That alumina and silica separate, that means it's a reactive form of a kaolin, that is a meta stage of kaolin. And that is reactive in form, in nature, and that helps to consume maximum lime from the concrete when lime is being generated during the hydration process. This metakaolin is reactive. I'm just going to show these things. And then always, yes, quality control is always there in at the time of raw material, at the time of during the process, and once the finished product is designed actually. So this is the activities and the production process of metakaolin. This is the only pozzolanic material we can say it's specially produced for the purpose. It is not just a byproduct and can, you know, convert into the such a manner so that the concrete is being concrete industry is using. Okay, that's the metakaolin is in a mineral add mixtures used in a partial replacement of cement for high strength and high value concrete. Metakaolin prepared, as I convey that, it is required a 650 to 900 temperature, and it has high pozzolanic reactivity. It is among all the pozzolanic material, it is among highest pozzolanic material, and chemical composition wise, it is an aluminosilicate with a that react with the calcium hydroxide, and it is again a byproduct. What I am talking about, like CaOH twice react with the metakaolin react with the COH ties during the hydration process, or as it is well noted, like metakaolin is a lime hungry pozzolanic material that react with the free lime and form stable or insoluble and a strength adding and cementitious compound. So next I'm coming to the moment at ready, how it look like. It is off-white product or little bit on a whiter tinge, that is in a powder form, having a fineness of 700 to 900 meters square kg. Light in form, like cement is again a 3 plus specific gravity. This is a 2.35 specific gravity material. It has very fine, 45 microns is almost a nil kind of a product. It is having an average particle of 1.5, whereas the cement must be having a 20 to 25 microns. So it is 100% material is finer than the cement lowest particles, like a 10 microns. And the specific surface area is, yes, it is a BD surface area. We can get this 9 to 15,000 gram per, otherwise 15 meter square per gram. And you see on the right side, like this is having a 96% of the material which is usable and which is always act in when it use into the concrete. Like alumina content is having a 42 to 43. SiO2 is contained, you can say, is a 55%. So total in between 96% of the active contains are there. So none of the material, none of the particles, like, you know, 4 to 5% except like alloy and all, Otherwise, all the materials are in reactive form and it is using into the system. It is always there in the system. Here you can also see the particles I was just talking about. The BET surface area is okay, fine, 9 to 15 in between. But you can see that if you see the particle of cement in a gray color line, which is having average particle of 20 to 25, whereas rope kaolin itself is a finer than the cement, but it is not in a reactive form and we process and convert into a reactive one that also with the for the fineness we achieved by using the grinding as well as cyclone separators. So consistent particle size distribution is also one of the unique parameter which we are going to get in meta kaolin. Judging kaolin and meta kaolin is always difficult actually. The machine says it is a difference. Otherwise, eyesight, we may not identify two powder put together. It is, we cannot identify. But you can see the XR here, like see the peak of this left hand side. It is non-reactive, it's only kaolin aluminosilicates. And on the right hand side, you can see there is none of the reactive, the quartz peaks are, you cannot see the quartz peak. It's all totally amorphous structures. You can see on a right hand side graph, which is a metakaolin and amorphous stage of aluminosilicate. So these are the difference between two, kaolin and metakaolin. Okay. And these are, as I said, like this is among all highest reactive material, like pozzolanic reactive material. You see the number, bauxite, it's a calcined bauxite, is having almost 400, 500 reactive contents. The consumption line hungriness is there. Silica fume is almost a 400, 500. Blast furnace slag is also, is having pozzolanic reactivity index is 3 according to the Chappell test I'm talking about. Whereas metakaolin is almost crossing 1000, 1011 plus actually. These are the data published and it is all open. Chappell test we can search. Metakaolin is the highest reactive material available in the industries. Because the quality control in all the all the steps is important factor here. So quality control in terms of raw material, in terms of the finished products is all we are taking care. Industry, it is required actually. And we follow this IS code. It is a recently published like 16354 dedicated to the metakaolin for use in a cement mortars and the concretes. Although international standards is also available, that is the ASTM C618 class N. And the specification is available, industry is open to use now. This you can see one picture of the first page of IS 16354. Fine. This metakaolin is modifying the concrete. Once you add into the concrete, it modifies the concrete properties by following three mechanisms actually. One is the pozzolanic reaction, as I explained, like it is having the exactly the highest pozzolanic reactive material. It is always powder form, it is always there. Physical actions are always there because of the fineness and all actually. So it pour the fields and pour water chemistry is the things. But you can see the picture. In the red zone, these are the fine powders. I'm talking about the metakaolin. Otherwise, the fine powders, what it takes their place in between the gap of two particles of cement, even actually. So porosity, seed density and high density of concrete is achievable by using this metakaolin. And you can see the advantages. We can achieve, number of things by using this metakaolin, and it is always supporting by increasing the compressive strength and flexural strength. It helps to improve durability, Metacritic always try to always fill the gap and reduce the permeability. Affluence is yes, and the chemical resistance you can achieve by using this, because it is it's reacting with the lime, and then it reduce good packing of the concrete is also possible by using this fine product. It's reduce the chloride migrations because of the low permeable concrete can be achieved. It increase viscosity, it enhance workability and finishing also. It's reduce effects of alkali silica reactive, because we don't know which type of aggregates we use, but there are a separate paper and separate study has done to specifically for the alkali silica reaction, and using metakaolin, it shows very much control is possible by using this metakaolin. It increases adhesion, binding, good binding can be possible. It reduces sinkage because no water left out in the porosity in between the two particles, and sinkage can be controlled. Yes, this is aesthetic look also can be achieved by using this, because these are all not in a gray color, it is a brighter tinge, so the white concrete or the lighter color concrete also, and it reduces the CO2. I'm just explaining more. This metakaolin can be used into all type of concrete. It's not like it is suitable for specific concretes, you know, like you can see like a high performance, high strength, mass concreting, low heat of hydrous concrete. There are a method of using this metakaolin. I'm not saying you few percentage of metakaolin always helps to achieve a low heat of hydration in a ternary blend mixes. Light colored concrete, I already explained, marine concrete for ultra fine, ultra thin, white topping is the, you know, the phase now. Many projects are going on white topping and high strength concrete. You can achieve by using metakaolin this WTH or white topping concrete can be produced, and few projects are already done in India as such. Industrial and commercial floors are there. Architectural concrete can be cast, and many other things. Even this material is used into many of the construction chemical people also, in the industry also, for designing the stucos and ready mix plasters and roof plasters and all. And lastly, I can say geopolymer concrete, you must have come across the lecture on the first day or second week. Metakaolin is the most suitable product for the geopolymer concrete also. There are results, there are published papers are also available how beneficial for the metakaolin for generating or producing this geopolymer concrete. So this metakaolin is high performance mineral admixtures, and it is indigenously produced in India, because all raw materials are all Indian, process technology is also Indian, and we can say on that all ground it is indigenously produced in India. A few experiment also we did in producing this metakaolin. We casted many concretes, many different. I'm just presenting few mixed designs. These are few slides are there. Few more slides also we will refer. You check here like the mix A is individual, mix B is individual, mix C, mix D. These are four different site design I mentioned. It is not a comparison with any of analog product actually. And the last mix E is a comparison between two. One is a metakaolin and the other industry available pozzolanic material, microsilica comparison is there. If we talk about the first, like mix A, is having a water binder ratio is 0.33, and mix B is we try to reduce 0.33 to 0.24, 0.22 and 0.21 in a different sites. First, you can see here using a 390 kg of cement, adding a 35 kg, tentatively a 9% of metakaolin, we can get concrete on a third day of 43 megapascal, whereas on a 28 days it is 84-85 megapascal concrete can be achieved, and we can see here the slump level of also it is a pourable concrete. Same way for mix B. Mix B, you can see here like water cement ratio is 0.24. We added more cement with pumpable concrete we casted in one of the high-rise building in Mumbai. Cement content we kept here 410. Added flies, it's a turnkey plant concrete, and added only 30 kg of metakaolin, kept water content of 144. And you see here, PC admixture we use of 404.92 kg, and flow we achieved almost 500 plus. It's a good pumpable concrete, and we completed one project where we achieved more than a 70 grade of a concrete. You can see the number below. On 28 days we achieved. Now we are switching to the mix C to mix D actually. Mix D is we casted with 450 kg of cement, 150 kg of fly ash. This pumpable concrete always needed this type of a fines, and 40 kg of metakaolin. Straight away I am coming to the flow is a 700, and see the strength on the third day, is it a more than a 55, 57 megapascal is achievable, and an M100 grade concrete is possible to achieve on 45 days. Number you can see here, 809 megapascal is achievable. So metakaolin is having a capability to produce more than 100 grade of concrete, depending on mixes and right aggregates is also always playing a role actually. And these are the four mixes of four different sites of Bombay, whereas the last, the product is well accepted, well giving a result compared to the other mineral admixture. I cannot say it is a pozzolanic admixture microsilica comparative mix. We kept cement water cement ratio as it is. We take 470 and 130 kg of a fly ash and added 60 kg of metakaolin. This comparison, we kept water same, water cement ratio same, just we changed to get consistent flow of a 500 plus 550 plus. We play with a little bit of a mineral admixture, chemical admixtures, and in a metakaolin concrete. It is using, we added, it's required only 10.3 kg of admixture, whereas more doses is required in an analog concrete, analog mineral. And strength part, you can check comparatively, it is achievable of on a 28 days, it is more than a 90 strength is achievable, same as in microsilica. So this is the things convey for metakaolin is well accepted as far as strength and flowability and other part. Other mixes you can see here, the mixes with the metasem again actually, this water cement ratio of 0.4, other mix comparison is there with the microsilica of water cement ratio of 0.33, and the third one is 25.25.24. The first one mix is 399 kg of cement, and we replace, we added a metakaolin by 26 kg, whereas in a strength part, it is apple to apple strength is achievable in regards to the mix A. Mix B, these are all ready mix concrete people. Plant results I have mentioned here. We conducted a separate trial and commercial mixes actually. These are M75 is achievable using a 450 kg of cement and 50 kg of microsilica compared to the metakaolin. And other comparison is done with the 450 kg. We use a 50 kg of metakaolin, and we reduce water cement ratio so that achievable of strength we achieve on a 7 days 68, whereas in a metakaolin case it is 75 plus, and on a 28 days the mix C is showing like 82 in a microsilica, whereas metakaolin is 84. So mean to say like on a 7 day high early strength is also achievable by using metacholine. So metacholine always supports to achieve high early strength. And RTPC test is also RCPC test is rapid chloride permeability test is also showing like it is less than a 400, less than a 500 columns are achievable by using metacholine. And permeability level is also less than a 14 is achievable. I'm switching over to the next slide of another mixes. These are other mixes. I'm not going to explain much. This is just for the reference I put here. Here also you can see on a 28 days, all the mixes is achievable by more than 80 strength is possible by using the metacholine. These are all, you know, these two numbers you can see 2.5. The mix A is showing the production and theoretical values. What theoretical values we expected to achieve 2,528, whereas actual production is also possible by 2,570. I'm just skipping this for the next slide. Here, now always question come what the percentage is like, because we did many trials like using somewhere in 26 kg, somewhere in 30 kg, somewhere in 50 kg and all. Actually these that was all the commercial mixes. We conducted dedicated trial just to look after or just to derive on what is the optimum level of metacin for getting right quality or the desired quality of concrete. We casted this, we conducted this trial at NCCBM. Control, you can see I'm 60 grade concrete with the 0.33. We kept water cement ratio as it is, water content same as it is, and use a 450 kg cement. First, we replace metacholine, we replace cement by metacholine 7.5%. The second and third mix, you can see like we reduce the cement by 10%, 450 to 405, and added a metacholine of 45 kg. And the third and fourth mix, we reduce again cement to the level of 394 and added a metacholine of 56.25 kg. Concrete is designed in a such a way so that can be poured properly, and this of aggregates little bit change in, and accordingly we design a concrete. And as far as result is concerned, control mix of M60 is showing day one strength is 23.6. Whereas by reducing cement of 7.5%, it increased to 28.8. So high early strength is achievable by replacing metacholine, by adding metacholine to the same stuff. And whereas in 28 days is concrete, control strength is a 58.8, whereas a 7.5% reduction in cement and addition of metacholine gives 64.5 megapascal. By replacing 10% is 64 to 68.9, and by replacing more percentage of 12.5, it reduces strength. Mean to say, to achieve a compressive strength, we can say like 7.5 to 10%. 10% is the ideal doses to get a right and desired compressive strength. 8 to 10% in between. Actually, adding a more metacholine will not give you a more strength. That is a clear cut picture we can see here. As far as flexural strength is concerned, yes, 10% is giving a perfect result, or almost a 2 count plus. Modulus of elasticity is also giving a good result at the level of 10, and even permeability is concerned. We can achieve less than, you know, in the range of 100 to 1000 level, we can achieve. Showing this data, just wanted to convey that the right optimum doses is 8 to 10% and not more, as far as, to achieving the compressive strength and modulus of elasticity and As far as chloride ion permeability, yes, it is giving a more metakaolin addition, is give you a less chloride permeability to the level of less than 260, 200 also can be achieved because of the fine structures. And so that was from the optimum doses level. Few projects wanted to show here in Bombay, completed one site of Molas Royale. It is 326 meter height where they use metakaolin right from the beginning, and it is already completed. Opposite that things, there is one small project, but again it is a high-rise building, not compared to the 300 meter. They also completed with M60 grade concrete here. I'm not showing much in data actually. That was from the India. This is the internationally metakaolin is also well accepted. This is where not our metakaolin, but it is a metakaolin. We completed this building, Park Avenue in New York. They completed 426 meter height of using BASF metakaolin there in US. And they use a white Portland cement plus metakaolin. That is the beauty of this building. And it is still there. We can refer the literature for more detail about metakaolin, how it performs, how they achieve the desired properties, what it is designed. And the other thing is, few of the bridges also completed in the New Benicia Martins Bridge. That is a California Department of Transportation has completed. It is open for the public now. These are another two foundations and all. A few projects I covered. There are many projects are completed using a metakaolin. And apart from, you know, the product, its process and all, we have to see the sustainable future also actually, and we people are the architecture for the sustainable futures. And how we can, you know, there were some lectures also I come to know that on a sustainable things has been already discussed in this few days sessions also. We have to, you know, keep in mind about the durability of the concrete, and it is almost important factor. More durable concrete give you long life, and no reconstructions and all are there. So that is a priority and utmost priority to produce. The other thing is, it is a well-known fact that the cement, and they are the major contributor to the greenhouse. So now technology has come. There also some reduction take place. Earlier data was like, you know, 1 ton for 1 ton cement production generate a 1 ton emission. You know, now it is reduced. I am not aware about exact data nowadays. So reduction in cement, I mean to say, like if we can replace by adding any of the mineral admixture which is not generating CO2 more than the cement, it is always advantage. Changes for the system as such. So we have to work for as lowest much cement consumption by achieving desired properties of the concrete. Metakaolin is one of them actually. Fly ash is there, slag is there, and metakaolin always help here to achieve the desired property of the concrete for the sustainability particularly I'm talking about. Other thing is aggregate is also, these are not in a, related to the metakaolin, but yes, extracting natural aggregate is also producing some more environmental issues and all that also we have to take it forward. Same way, like if we use recycled aggregate, crushed blocks and all, that also helps to reduce overall consumption of the nature things. And again, lightweight aggregate is also can be used, made from the wastage and all. That also helps to reduce our consumption, overall consumption of the natural aggregates and natures. Geopolymer is one of the option. for the sustainable move, and other engineers are always working, and we have to appreciate for that. So this was in regards to the metakaolin, what I wanted to convey. And thank you very much for all. If time is there, then I can talk for a few slides for the ultrafine mineral also, ultrafine material. डॉक्टर साहब इज इट ओके फॉर टाइम है तो फिर मैं बात करता हूँ एक छोटे से दो चार स्लाइड्स से
बिल्कुल करें सर बिल्कुल करें सर वेलकम सर
ओके एज पर एज बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद दिस अल्ट्रा फाइन मटेरियल्स एंड ऑल इज देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस टू डिस्कस और
हाँ एनी पार्टिसिपेंट इफ एनी क्वेरी रिगार्डिंग मेटाकाओलिन मे बी आस्क्ड एट दिस
मेटाकाओलिन यस we can discuss, and then after I can just show only few slides of what we did for a small way for this, and it is our commercial material is there now actually for the ultrafine material. A few slides we can discuss later.
In between, one participant had written in chat, you may refer to mm-hmm. it. Is it foldable concrete? Dr. Dipali Paresh Doshi, if she is here, she may elaborate on that.
Honestly, I can, I can try at least.
Dr. Dipali, if you are here, may kindly elaborate on the question. Any other question by any other participant, please? Since you may continue with ultrafine material slides and then... Okay. Dr. Dipali says she cannot unmute. So I am... Dr. Dipali, now you can unmute. I have enabled you. Dr. Dipali, you can unmute yourself now. I have enabled you to unmute. Anyway, Mr. Sir, aage chale.
If it is so, that we'll refer and we'll try to cover it up by mail, or we can communicate some other way also. Like
definitely. If the question is received on mail, I shall forward you.
Perfectly right. So we discuss about the metakaolin, how it is produced, and that was the reactive in nature. We being a micronized mineral, like 20 microns limited is a company name actually, and we produce different mineral in a such a fine stage. And generally we produce our product for the paint industries, plastics industries and paper industries and all actually. And a few time back when we interact with Dr. Agarwal, he told me like to work out for the ultrafine materials also. And India, it is not that popular. Other area, yes, these are the popular product, and people are always trying to incorporate this into their concrete system. Few trials we also conducted, and few projects we are already doing, and India is also accepting little bit of this material, which is not in that reactive form like a metakaolin and microsilica, but it is giving the precipitations and all. And the main thing is these are all a particle packing theory, this box, this material actually. The concrete is a technical product, and which is produced worldwide in a vast amount, and that's why things comes into the picture. Like if we are producing a white fine microfine material, then why can't we try into the concrete itself? So it is material, particularly this ultrafine material, is in general, it is a relatively low cost available. It is giving really a very good durability also can help, and it is easy to applications also. As I convey, like no cement, No concrete. That is the current scenario. And I mentioned the cement is producing 900 kg of carbon dioxide while producing 1 ton of cement. Here we can say if we reduce cement by adding any of natural mineral, it may be produced by using wastage material or the material which is not generating carbon dioxide much, which is always beneficial to use into the concrete system. You can see here the cement is, if we produce 1 ton of cement, it produces 900 kg of carbon, whereas ultra-fine non-cementitious material of average particle of 1 micron or 2.5 microns is produced only the 40 to 45 kg of carbon emission. So considering this fact, we try to produce such a fine mineral additives we use into the concrete and try to evaluate how the result it gives a result, and we found it is giving a really a very good result. And I'm skipping all this stuff, whereas I am coming to the straightaway particle packing theory. The same picture I am showing you once again. You can see here the porous structure, and if we analyze exact porosity of the concrete, and accordingly we can design ultra-fine particles pour into that concrete while designing the concrete, which is always taking place of water, and reduce the porosity, overall porosity, and increase the density of the concrete, and it helps in a many way. Just I'm coming to the generally high performance concrete was the subject, and where we were talking about M60, M80, M90, and M100 grade of concrete. Here I am talking about the concrete which is maximum used into the industries like MM30 and M40 grade concrete. So M30 here you can see the comparison. The control mix is having a 290 kg of cement, whereas modified mix is a 270 kg of cement. What we did actually, these are the mixes and crusher strand. We replace 10 kg of, we reduce the cement of a 10 kg. We added ultra fine material. What I am talking about, ultra fine material A, and again ultra fine material B. There are two different type of ultra fine mineral we use for this experiment. We added SNF here to get consistent flow. And the next slide, you can see the result. Before that, we analyze particle size distribution also for the product what I am we are use what we use. Cement D50 was a 20, whereas the fly ash we checked D50 of 16 to 17, whereas ultra fine A mineral is with D50 of 5 microns, and ultra fine B mineral of D50 of 2.5 microns. Idea is to ultra fine, but which size, like 1 micron, 5 micron, 15 micron, like what actually? So these two difference, mix A is with average particle of 5, and B mix B with average particle of 2.5, that we use here for this experiment. And the next is the result below the things. We check the compressive strength. The first is the workability is always mentioned here. After this, the control concrete was, it was a 0 minute, then the 60 minutes, and then the B is possible to achieve a 90 minute cycle. This three is the result as such. So first control mix, we get slump of 160, whereas mix A was having average particle of 5, 0 minute slump was 180, and mix B average particle of that I admix microfine product was 2.5, and that is on a 0 minute slump was almost collapse. same things we experiment after 60 minutes, and it is giving it reduce the slump of 160 to 140 in a control, whereas modified mix of A and mix B is reduced to 180 to 140 and call ups to 150, because time after 60 minutes it was like that. And the last is we waited for 90 minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes, and the mix control mix has given only 100 slumps, whereas mix addition of 5 microns product and addition of a 2.5 microns product, it gives a more slump, more pourable concrete. And then we are coming to the strength point of view. Here, workability comparison, what I have already explained, and these are the compressive strength. So numbers are okay again for the discussion. Compressive strength on a day one of a control mix was given on 6.4, whereas you can see mix B with the average particle of 2 microns or 2.5 microns was we achieved by 10.3. Almost a 40% strength enhancement is possible by adding ultra fine material in a concrete system. I'm just keeping day 3, day 7, day 14 and day 18 and straight away coming to the day 14 of from 6 to 33, whereas 10 to at least to the 38 MPa concrete is possible on MPa on a 14 days. Whereas on 28 days, it was a mix of control is giving 37.9 MPa, which is so one grade higher concrete is achievable by using ultra fine material, replacing only 10 kg of the ordinary Portland cement. And it gives many other advantages of low permeability and other properties actually. So that was the things as conveyed to talk about two product, metakaolin and ultrafine. Now we are working on the nanoparticles also. And once the experiment completed, definitely we'll share the results. So that will be our next nanoparticle. Also, we are working on a calcium carbonate or other minerals, or maybe the silica. And as and when we'll complete the study and all, we'll definitely share more result about this ultrafine product as far as nano sizes is concerned. So that was the small things from my side. I guess I completed this all on time, what was given.
Definitely you have done a very brief treatment. So I request participants to unmute themselves. I have enabled unmute. So Mrs. Dipali, Dr. Dipali, or any other participant wish to air their queries, please.
Hello. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon. Very well
audited. Sir, in ultra microfine particles, from where you are preparing that particles? And one more thing, the size of the particle is lower than the clay particle, no?
I am not getting you properly. Actually, ultrafine mix properly. Ultrafine mix.
Ultrafine mix. You are using ultrafine mix.
Okay.
So, from where you are getting that thing? Have you prepared in your company?
Yes, this we produce by using raw lumps.
By using raw lumps.
And we crush, we grind, we ball mill, the things, and we separate the particle size. We control the particle size distribution so that the consistency can be, achieved. It is
achieved. Okay. Then particles.
Your voice is not that fluent.
Sir, size of ultrafine particles are less than clay particles?
No. The clay particle is similar, like a clay particle is 1.5 to 2.
Clay particle is 1.2 micron,
whereas this we experiment is 2.5.
Okay.
Less than 2 microns, yes. Average for D50 is 2 microns.
Okay. And sir, the have you performed this plasticity index or anything? Is it a non-plastic material or plastic?
Ultrafine is a non-plastic material.
Okay, because clay is a
plastic. But it always gives a good plasticity of the concrete because it used into the, you know, filling the pore and there won't be any voids left out so that the good bonding is possible. So brittleness stays.
Main is to reduce the permeability. Yes.
Base is to fill the gap. That is the initial idea of designing this product and conducting the trials. That's why I have shown only compressive strength part only. There are many things to be worked out actually. You are absolutely right.
And sir, one more thing, that was my question. Is it foldable or not? Because in morning lecture, some plasticizer they are using and make that concrete as a foldable. Is it possible in your product?
It is possible because of concrete designed with the natural minerals.
Okay.
If some plasticizers and some product, I have not attended their things. If that support to produce a foldable concrete, that is an entirely different technology actually.
Okay.
And they must have used minerals in the concrete. This also can support, but very difficult now to say yes or yes.
Okay, sir. It's a last one question.
Yes.
Sorry, is it eco-friendly? Because you told that it reduces the CO2 consumption.
Yes, comparatively, because it helps to reduce the cement.
Okay.
Cement is producing more CO2.
Yeah.
Whereas metakaolin and this material is producing less CO2. Other thing is the material which is being used into the concrete nowadays, which is to achieve more than a 70 and more than a 100 grade of concrete, which is required to import from other countries.
Okay.
So the transportation cost, where the whatever the emission is being generated, this material is locally available. You need not to travel. This material need not to travel what the other material is traveling.
And we can follow the Modi's Make in India program.
Yes, madam. We respect them and there is always our little bit of contribution there to use a local material.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Misty sir, your voice is echoing. So if you are using two systems, may kindly.
No, I am using only one.
Okay. Then now it is okay. In last.
Acha.
Okay. Anyway, any other participant, please.
Possibly.
Yes, please.
Sir.
One voice is coming, madam.
Yes. Hello? Yes, please, madam.
Sir, regarding metakaolin. So you can see in RMC we'll be using the fly ash like a partial replacement. So whether metakaolins are reached to the public, sir, any comment on it, sir?
No, I'm not getting you. People are using ternary blend actually. Fly ash is always essential to use for pumpable concrete actually.
So
it is always advantage.
Actually, my question is it is already reached to the public.
Metakaolin is also now easily available. We also work since long actually, and almost all the ready mix concrete people and industry is also aware. Still, the awareness is not that much what fly ash and other mineral. I am agree with you, but this metakaolin is easily available in India now. No problem.
But it is not reached easily because they are not accepting it. Only in the research point of view, we are using it.
Yes, that is a drawback of the industry. People have started. No, it is in the Bombay specifically where M60 grade concrete and M80 grade is concrete. Few people have already started commercially. As far as few area in India, still we have to work a lot. Still industry have to work a lot. And more the engineers come to know, more the acceptance can be, possible like.
Section, sir. Thank you, sir. A very informative section.
Professor,
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Professor Sudarshan has written me a query. One participant is, he wants to know, have you done any cost estimation studies? If I want to construct a residential apartment of 1000 square feet, how much cost it
okay.
involves? How much cost it involves?
Okay, honestly, such kind of a study I have not done. But yes, it is a cost addition, but cost advantage is always there actually, because these are additives and it will always increase the little bit cost as far as the concrete construction at the time of concrete designing. But this material always give you a durability and a long lasting structures and other more advantages actually. So cost addition is there, but cost advantage is the other factors to be apple to apple. If we check the cost, initial cost, metakaolin is little bit high. Any additives if you add, it will be always add cost only, but it is a cost advantages are there.
At this point,
exact number is difficult to convey. Yeah.
At this point, of course, not cost point of view, I wish to share some informally the some mm-hmm. part of the studies done by my M.Tech students and B.Tech project students on this the products which Ms. Sisa has been talking about may be benefit to all. One part
yes.
is that NIT Trichy, yes. NIT Trichy students, I guided a student project. They came for the project at IIT and IIT professor diverted to me. So I guided two students there, then two batches rather. One batch, two girls came and then two boys came next year. So first of all, when the two girls came from NIT Trichy, we made firstly, at least at IIT Roorkee, we made in 2002 the concrete with metakaolin M60, M70. AK Jensa was their official guide, the two girls. He was so impressed by the results that he called me and we discussed results. Then we continued with the Somnath Sharma and Varni Pandey, again two students of NIT Trichy. And then we carried out durability test. RCPT was procured at that time in IIT Roorkee by, of course, my involvement and the resistivity test. So we found that we could reduce the cement content. We could enhance resistivity value to 70 as compared to the resistivity value less than 10 of the same strength concrete without metakaolin. So this was the beauty, that durability enhancement was too much. Resistivity of concrete, as all of you or many of you might be knowing, that is the major factor for risk assessment or risk vulnerability of concrete and against corrosion. Then we had some two M.Tech thesis at Rajasthan Technical University, Kota, with the metakaolin in the years to come. Then both of them, one was with fly ash and metakaolin. Results were so good that that fellow, his senior section engineer in railways, is trying again and again, writing me again and again, sir, I want to extend this study for my PhD, take me. Because he himself found that this ternary blend of fly ash and metakaolin proved to be very good. And another student, two students, M.Tech students, did work on the ultra fine materials of calcium carbonate, taking material from 20 micron limited. Simply, I'm talking of those M.Tech first, that simply 5 micron average size, adding small mm-hmm. quantity increased durability as well as strength. One B.Tech project I remember very, very fondly, I reproduce to my students that then one B.Tech final year project I gave, where his material, 20 micron material, with ultra fine size. I think vapor light is the name or something. So
vapor light is
the name. We used very 0.2% of the cement content. 0.2% of the cement.
Okay.
Mind me, participants, 0.2% addition in of the cement content doubled its strength in 48 hours. Doubled its strength. Of course, then we tested for durability parameters. It was wonderful. Nobody could, I myself did not believe when the students brought me, sir, this is the results of 48 hours. 50 MPa strength of 2 days with cement.
2 days.
With cement of around 350 or 330 kg per meter cube. That is what is the beauty. Of course, we used fly ash also. So I fully support whatever the Mistisa was saying, because I have myself and with my students done experiments in the lab. Of course, since last 4 or 5 years, I'm not getting time. But before that, I have been very active in this pursuing ultrafine materials research and all, of course. And now one more thing I wish to share with the participants, that Nehdi's paper, I remember Nehdi.
Nehdi's, yes.
Cement and Concrete Research Journal, Nehdi's paper of 2005. There are two papers, and one was published again in 2006. The participants can refer that. There he is talking about four or five mechanisms of fly ash in concrete. Same thing applies. I have myself examined microstructure and found that Nehdi's observations that ultrafine powder addition acts not only as densifying agent, not only as pozzolanic agent if it is reactive, but also acts as nuclei for further hydration. That is the main finding of Nehdi, which was published first time in the world. So this is what the ultrafine powders have been doing, because that BTEC project, I was so astonished. I took the samples for SAM and TAM and found this. So this is the advantage of using ultrafine powder. Further participants can ask from the learned speaker.
And we are also working for, you know, that the material what you use, it was a 1 to 1.5 micron size. We are also working for 0.7 microns also. And we are gathering more details also, so that this material can be commercial and can serve into the Indian industries actually.
And he's right. We have compared in BTEC and MTEC projects with the performance given by the silica fume. Ternary, most of you must be knowing, or many of you must be knowing, that my PhD area was high strength self-compacting concrete with ternary blend. So I have worked extensively with fly ash and micro silica. So definitely whenever we experimented with metakaolin, definitely we compared the results with the silica, micro silica and fly ash combination. So fly ash and metakaolin combination and fly ash and micro silica combination. That was
micro silica.
Yes. So participants may involve discussion with the experts. Any participant, please. Someone has written on chat, I think. Very excellent session, wonderful presentation. So, and question.
Thank you very much.
Question answer session. One, Sudarshan sir has written, have you studied any trail study with carbon nanotubes in concrete?
Carbon nanotube is a different product actually. There is a mineral called halocytes. So we have not done anything as far as metakaolin and other ultrafine product is concerned that I can say like. But yes, nanotube is again, it's a subject for some R&D is going on at my end actually, and definitely I will share whatever it is possible to the forum again. If we get any of positive indication, but yes, natural mineral available in a nano tube size, carbon tube, what it is generally say, the natural it is, halosite is a mineral which is giving a good nanotube kind of mixtures.
So if there are no further queries, may I propose closure of this session?
That is fine. And thank you very much for all the support. And if you have any queries and all, yes, we can reach. And if we can, serve more to the industries, we'll definitely try more and more. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Sir. Pleasure is mine and ours for being with us and for accepting my request to be with us. And thank you so much. Thank you for the ever
thanks.
Support.
Thanks a lot. Thank you for your ever support.
And with your permission, I stop the recording.